Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to Lions Live Show, where we are living live.
It's time for the sports teams to celebrate. More info on the way.
You used to have records? Well, we have a lot of records coming up for you in a few.
Prediction that Mexico or Russia will take home the FIFA World Cup. Yes, FIFA World Cup. That's our story on today's Around the World segment.
Well, have you heard the forecast today? Find out more.
Tesla becomes a finalist for a national demonstration school for Springboard. Stick around and we'll be right back.
For a national demonstration school for the Springboard curriculum. Because teachers have implemented the program so well and students have exceptionally received it, TESLAF has been recognized on a national level. We will show a special video today that highlights how the Springboard curriculum is used. We had plans to air yesterday, but ran out of time. You can watch it immediately following our show today in the place of Channel 1.
Are you renting this year's Red Carpet Media Festival? If so, the deadline to enter your videos and photos is May 1st. Remember, everyone is able to compete and you can enter as many times as you want. Winners will be announced at the Red Carpet Media Festival on May 31st and will get to go to Hollywood on June 3rd. Again, the deadline is approaching in just 3 weeks, so get your videos and photos in right away to room 205. You can find more info at tesloffmiddleschool.com or redcarpetmediafestival.com.
The sports banquet for the boys' soccer and girls' basketball team will be held next Wednesday, April 17, after school in the cafeteria. It will begin promptly at 2:15 p.m. and there will be plenty of food, drinks, treats, and awards for the team's MVPs and coach awards winners. So again, girls' basketball and boys' soccer teams, don't forget your celebration next Wednesday.
Don't forget, when you buy a lunch at TESLAF, you have to get a fruit or vegetable. TESLAF doesn't just help you get ready for high school and beyond, they also help you become more stronger and fit. Again, each student is required to pick up a fruit or vegetable when purchasing a lunch in the cafeteria.
Are you a mad scientist who loves competition? On May 18th, TESLAF will participate in the district's annual Science Olympics. A list of events will be posted near your science class. Choose an event and sign up with a listed teacher before spring break, or right now. Put your knowledge to the test and go have fun practicing. Then on May 18th, TESLAF will bring home some medals to brag about.
The Principal Challenge is back. The new book is I Am Number 4 by Pittacus Lohr. When you read the book, make sure you take the AR quiz before April 16th. The movie date is April 19th.
Time now to bring on the laughs as we go to Sierra with today's funny segment.
Looks like little Lucy is enjoying that birthday present. Watch as this baby attacks the cake.
Oh my gosh, oh, she's laying her in.
Lucy, is that so funny?
Well, I guess she liked the cake. I'm not so sure about the whole getting messy thing. Well, that's a wrap, and someone please clean that baby.
Time out across the globe with Dylan. Good morning, Dylan.
Thank you, Jersey, and good morning, Trojans. Do you know what the most popular tournament in the world is? The 2014 Brazil FIFA World Cup is the most watched sporting event ever on the planet. The last World Cup in 2010 reached the record-shattering 36.2 billion television viewers worldwide. Next year's World Cup is expected to have more television viewers. There will also be 12 stadiums in total that the teams will play in consecutively, with four of those being constructed right now. The World Cup will consist of 132 teams that will be reduced to 64 teams. Those teams will be reduced to 32, then 8, then 16, then to the quarterfinals that consist of 8 teams. Eight will make it to the semifinals, then to the glorious finals, where the winning team will be crowned as the best international team in the world. The actual trophy is 14 inches tall and is made of 18 karat gold. Spain claimed the 2010 Soccer Cup, and soccer fans are predicting that Mexico or Russia will take home the World Cup. That wraps up here. Time to go to Jersey for your upcoming test-off events.
Thank you, Dylan. Today is Georgian Pride Day and fundraiser prize party. Friday is minimum day and college day. That takes care of our schedule. Let's go to Jennifer for a live flight forecast.
Okay, thank you, Jersey. Okay, so, yeah. Kind of got to let it load. Okay, so looking at the map, we see 75 in Los Angeles, and then as we go up top, we have 70 in San Francisco. On the East Coast, we have 59 in Boston, and then up in the mountain area over here, we have 29 degrees. Let's go to our five-day forecast. We have 79 today with a low of 55, and tomorrow the clouds will come out with 71. Friday will drop down to 70 and come back to 71 on Saturday. 68 and will cool down with 68 degrees. Let's go to Jefferson with the weather poll. Good morning, Jefferson.
Good morning, Jennifer. For this week's weather poll, we have Mark with us. Good morning, Mark.
Good morning.
Will you please get this week's weather poll?
Sure. Should Tesla students be permitted to go off campus during lunch?
Here's what you told us, Trojans. Yes, because we will have more food options. Another said no, because it will be easier to ditch. We want to hear from you. Be sure to visit online at livefaction.com or face page to vote. Send your comments to webpoll at livefaction.com, and it's good, we read on air. So Mark, what do you think?
I think that we should be able to go because the lunch line is too long, and we could just go to Target and buy food and candy.
Where would you go if you like buy other stuff?
Or we could go to Pizza Hut because it's just right there.
Thank you for joining us today. Let's go to Mario with the Live and Five Sports.
Thanks, guys. So we're going to go real a little fast, so sorry if you don't understand me. So for your women's NCAA, the Final Four champions, Connecticut beat Louisville by 33 points after Louisville set a record hitting 13 threes to beat Baylor by two. So we're going to go to the NBA. The Black Mamba, the one with the hot hand but cold-blooded, yes, you know who I'm talking about, Kobe Bryant led the Lakers to beat New Orleans 104-96, and they need one more win to secure spot in the playoffs. The Knicks set a season and franchise record hitting 23-pointers in one game to beat the Knicks, to let the Knicks beat the Wizards 120-99. And we're gonna go over some records. 16 three-pointers were made by Louisville to beat Baylor. 23-pointers were made by the Knicks to beat the Wizards. And the longest win streak so far in NBA history was 16 games. It was the 16-game winning streak set by the Clippers. Now we're going to pass it out to find out some more interesting information from Janiyah.
Thanks, Marianne. Okay, time now for your daily 411.
What is a minerite? What is a minuete? Volleyball, football, soccer ball, or baseball? Take five. Got it. A minuete? Oh, minuete. Okay, the volleyball was originally called a minnow net when it started in 1895.
Okay, no shout outs, no lights, so let's just go.
Visit our website to watch today's broadcast online at 11.5show.com. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at 11.5show.
That's all for our show. We'll see you back here tomorrow.
Woo. Hey, there's no light on Jennifer.